On many occasions, we need to deploy a machine learning model on cell phone, on microcontroller, or a wearable device like a Fitbit. Usually, machine learning models are of bigger size, so if they're running in a cloud on a big machine, it's okay. But if you want to deploy them on edge devices, by edge devices, I mean all these devices which I just mentioned, then we need to optimize the model and reduce the model size. So when you reduce the model size, it fits the requirement of a microcontroller. Microcontroller might have only few megabyte of memory, so it meets the requirement of limited resources, and also the inference is much faster. In this video, we will look into a technique called quantization, which is used to make basically a big model a smaller one so that you can deploy on edge devices. We'll go through some theory and then we'll do coding as well as usual. We'll convert a Tensorflow model into TF-Lite model and we'll apply quantization. Let's begin. Devices like microcontroller, wearable devices have less memory compared to your regular computer. And quantization is a process of converting a big TF model into a smaller one so that you can deploy on edge devices. By edge devices, I mean all these devices. Small devices are called edge devices. And if you look at your neural network model, when you save this model on a disk, you are essentially saving all the weights. These weights are float. Sometimes they use float 64 precision, which is 8 bytes. So to store one number, you are using 8 bytes. Sometimes you might be using 4 bytes. So let's say you are using 4 bytes to store your one weight. And by the way, I have shown you a very simple neural network. Actual neural networks are much bigger. So many layers, so many neurons. Now, if you convert this weight into integer, let's say you are just approximating this number from 3.72 to 3, then you can reduce your memory storage from 4 byte to 1 byte. This is int 8, by the way. And if you're using 8 bytes, and if you go from 8 bytes to 1 byte, that is a huge saving in terms of memory. So quantization is basically converting all these numbers, which requires more bytes to store in each individual number, into, let's say, int. So it's not always int. Sometimes you are converting from float 64, which is 8 byte, to float 16, which is 2 bytes. Even that case also, you are reducing the memory size. So that is basically quantization. It's a simple approach. Now, you're not blindly converting these weights into numbers. For example, here you have 3.23. You might not be saving that as 3. Maybe you are saving it as 4. There is an algorithm that you have to apply, and I'm not going to cover that. You can read the research paper online on how exactly quantization works. In this video, I will just keep it to, you know, a very higher level. Higher level, you are basically reducing your precision, and each individual weight that you want to store, you are using maybe int 8 or float 16, so that overall size of the model can be reduced. And obvious benefits are, you can deploy your model on a microcontroller, which might have only few megabytes of memory. And even the prediction time is much faster. So the performance when you're, you know, actually making prediction is much faster if your model is, let's say, int 8. There are two ways to perform quantization in TensorFlow: post-training quantization and quantization-aware training. In post-training quantization, you take your trained TF model and you use TF-Lite convert. By the way, if you don't know TF-Lite, TF-Lite is used to convert these models into smaller ones so that you can deploy on edge devices. Now, when you do this conversion, you can see this is a bigger circle, this is little smaller circle, so it will already reduce the size because the memory format that it is using is different. But if you apply quantization at the time of conversion, it will make it even more smaller. You see the smaller circle here on the right hand side? Previously it was bigger, but when you apply quantization, the model size is much smaller. Now, this is a quick approach, but the accuracy might get suffered. So the better approach is quantization aware training. In this case, you take TF model, then you apply quantize model function on it, and you get a Q model. In TensorFlow, we are talking about TensorFlow. and then you do training again. So this is more like a transfer learning, you know, you are doing fine tuning here. So you're taking your model, quantization, you're doing quantization, and on quantized model, you're fine tuning that. You are running the training again, maybe for fewer epochs, and you get fine tuned quantized model, and that you convert again using TF Lite. See, if you want to deploy TensorFlow model on edge devices, you have to use TF Lite. You have to do TF Lite conversion. That step cannot be avoided. This approach is little more work, but it gives you a more accuracy. Now let's do some coding so that you get an exact idea. I'm going to use a notebook which I created in one of my deep learning videos. So if you go to YouTube, search for Core Basics Deep Learning, you'll find my tutorial playlist. Here I made a video on digits classification. So I have taken a notebook from here. If you don't know the fundamentals, I highly recommend you watch this video first and then you continue with this particular video. So here, as you can see, I have trained a handwritten digit classification model in TensorFlow, and then I have exported that into a saved model. See, model.save, save model. And that created this save model directory. And the size of this directory is around 1 megabyte. I have a very simple model, but in reality, if you're using a big complex model, the size might go even in gigabytes. Now, first approach we're going to explore is post-training quantization. For that, you will use tf.lite module. So TensorFlow has this tf.lite module, which allows you to convert your model into tf.lite format. You will use tf.lite converter format, and a method that you're going to use is from saved model. So here you can supply the directory where you have your saved model, and this will return you a converter, and you can simply call converter.convert, and that will return you a tf.lite model. So this approach is what we discussed during our presentation, which is without quantization. So even if you directly convert using tf.lite model, your model size will be a little less, but if you use quantization, it will be even more less. So this is without quantization, and if you look at the size, by the way, this is just the bytes, okay, and you can get a rough understanding, it is around 312 kilobyte. Now I will use quantization. For quantization, just copy paste this code and only add one line, and that line is optimizations is equal to this, and now you got your quantized model, and the size of this quantized model is much less, it is almost 1/4. So by doing this, you converted this into an integer, you converted all the weights to integer, okay. And if you want to read more about this API and what other options you have here, I'm going to link an article in a video description below where, you know, we have used this method, which is just quantizing the weights. You can also quantize activations too. That will be even more better. That's called full integer quantization. And you have to use this particular code. Okay, now let me save these two models into a file. So I'm going to just write this model into a file. So I will call it, I'll first save non-quantized model, and the extension is tf.lite. Since it's a bytes data, I will use write and bytes mode as f, and then f.write, well, this particular one. And I can copy paste this and do the same thing for quantized model. So here, when execute it, both the files are returned here, see? This model is how much? 312 kilobyte without quantization. with quantization, 82 kilobyte. Hooray! 1/4 size reduction. Now let's talk about quantization aware training. Post-training quantization is quick, but the accuracy might get suffered. With quantization aware training, you can get better accuracy. You need to first import the model optimization called TF mode from your TensorFlow, and I will use a method called quantize model. Okay, so I'm going to use this method called quantize model here, and let me just save it in a variable so that I don't have to write this whole thing all the time. And I'm going to, this is basically a function which I'm going to call on my regular model. My regular TensorFlow model is this. You see model variable? I'm applying that quantize model method on that, and I get my quantization aware model. So if you go to my presentation, see this is the first step. On your regular TF model, apply quantize model function, you get quantize model. Then you have to fine tune. This is like transfer learning. You have to run training on that model again, maybe with less epoch. So I'm going to compile this particular model. Okay, and for compile, I have used same parameter as I used here originally. And I'll quickly display the summary. Before, you know, fine tuning, you need to compile, and then the summary just shows, you know, how many parameters, non-trainable, trainable, and so on. And I will use the training only for one epoch. Okay, I think one epoch is good. You're already getting 98% accuracy. And let's measure that on my test data set accuracy is also like 97%, so my accuracy looks beautiful. And now I'm going to use again the same converter. Okay, but for this converter, previously we use what, from save model, because we were loading from the disk. Here I will use a different API, from Keras model. So you use from Keras model if you are loading an in-memory model. Okay, and then that will get you converter, and then you are using the same technique. See, converter optimizations. Let me do this. So optimizations. So here you are applying quantization here, and then you are actually running quantization aware training. So it is two step. You first run quantization aware training, and then during the TF light conversion, you apply the quantization. Okay, and I will save it in a different variable. Okay, and let's write this as well to a file, because these are just the bytes that you got. You need to write it to a file with extension TF light. So now what I got, so if you go back to my, you know, diagram, you quantize, then you do fit for fine tuning, then you do your ultimate TF light conversion. Okay, and the size of this model is 80 kilobyte. Without quantization aware training, it was 82 kilobytes. So now it's, we are reducing it even further. And the main benefit of this model is the accuracy is little better compared to the other approach that we took. So just to quickly summarize, in this notebook, we trained our model in a usual way. We saved it to our hard disk. We saw the size was 1 megabyte. Then we did post-training quantization. Our quantized TF light model was around 300, and without quantization, it was 312 kilobyte. Then we got 82 kilobyte, 84 kilobyte model, 82 kilobyte actually. And then when we ran quantization aware training, we got, you know, 80 kilobyte model. But the main benefit of this model was the training accuracy is much better. I'm going to link few articles in the video description below, so you can read through those articles. The purpose of this video was just to give you overview of quantization. This notebook is available in the video description below. So friends, please try it out. Just by watching video, you're not going to learn much unless you practice on your own. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. That is the session fees. You know, that is this training session fees. You can do at least that much. If you don't like it, you know, give it a thumbs down. I'm fine. But leave me a comment so that I can improve in the future. And share it with your friends. I have a complete deep learning tutorial series, by the way. You see, complete deep learning tutorial series, which you can benefit from. There are so many exercises as well. And I try to explain things in a simple way. So share it with your friends who wants to learn deep learning. Thank you.